In this video, we'll be exploring how to connect Shopify to Autopilot through Zapier. To get started, we need to set up a Zap that fires when customers have their fulfillment status marked as shipped in Shopify to add them to our order fulfilled list in Autopilot. To do this, you'll need to navigate to your Zapier dashboard and select Make a Zap. Next, select or search for Shopify and select the trigger event. In this case, we're using updated order as we want to fire this Zap when a contact's order is updated to shipped. Select Continue and select your Shopify account. Click Continue again. In the Customize Order section, use the drop-downs to select exactly why you want your Zap to fire. We'll leave the payment and order status options on the default selection, but select Shipped from the Fulfillment Status menu. When you're happy with your selection, click Continue. You'll now be asked to test your trigger between Shopify and Zapier to ensure it will work correctly. Click Test and you'll see the data populate. Click Continue. For the second section, we'll be connecting to Autopilot. Select or search for Autopilot and select the action event. For this, we'll be using the Add Contacts to List option. Select Continue. Next, select your Autopilot account from the drop-down and click Continue. In the Customize Contacts section, you'll need to select the data you'd like to zap to Autopilot. You can map as many or as little of these fields as you like, depending on if you already have the contact information in Autopilot. We'll be selecting the list in Autopilot that we'd like to map these contacts to from the dropdown, and selecting the email field from Shopify to match in Autopilot. It's important to note that you'll need to have your list created in Autopilot before you set up your Zap, as you can't create a new list within Zapier. When you're happy with your field mappings, select Continue. You'll now see a preview of the data you'll be mapping to Autopilot. If this all looks good, you can select Test and Continue. If you need to change something, you can always select Test and Review. Click Done Editing when you're ready. Now that your Zap is built, be sure to give it a name and turn it on. You'll be shown a confirmation message that confirms your Zap is working. Back in Autopilot, we've then created a small operational journey that allows us to timestamp the order fulfilled date by configuring an update field shape with today. We've then created a smart segment using this list and the field date of order fulfilled that lets us track customers with orders that have been fulfilled 14 days ago. We've used this time frame to ensure that the customer's order will have arrived and they will have had time to enjoy their new purchase without feeling the pressure to purchase again immediately. Now we can build out a journey that will recognize when a contact has recently made a purchase and send them incentives to purchase again. To start our journey, we've used a smart segment trigger configured with the segment. We've also used the add contacts that are added to this segment in the future option for this trigger, as we want to ensure we're picking up all our future orders. Following this, a send email shape will send our contacts our latest sales offer and some recommended products that are similar to their last purchase. Following a 3-day delay, we'll then send them another email, this time with content specific to the same category that they last purchased. From here, you can continue the nurture in the same pattern until they purchase again. We've also used an add to Google audience shape to target these customers on our social channels, ensuring we stay top of mind and relevant. This nudging customers to purchase again journey is a perfect example of the benefits of integrating Shopify with Autopilot through creating an automated process by which you can generate repeat purchases from your customers without having to do any of the work.